Huge update on this storm and the weather pattern we're about to go into, everyone. It's about to start ramping up once again. Now, this is where our front is stalled. This is where we still have all this moisture coming through, and our severe weather has ramped up once more. We have enhanced risk for strong tornadoes all the way until Saturday. So for today, you can see that we do have that enhanced feature moving through. This is going to be chances for strong tornadoes as well, mostly on the southern side. I will show you. For tomorrow, it has ramped up with another moderate section. This is all going to be chances for strong tornadoes. And as we go through for Saturday, it also another enhanced feature. This is also going to strengthen up for chances not only large hail, but chances for tornadoes, even some of them strong. Now, we still have what's for Sunday. This is still a milder risk, but it's still going to push through towards the southeast. I even think that we'll see a little ramp up of tornado risk for southern Alabama, panhandle of Florida, as we go through for that as well. But we do have the watch going on for tonight. We do have a lot of severe weather going through. Right now, this is a watch for 70 miles per hour max wind gusts, 1.5 inches of hail. Right now, it is not a PDS, a particularly dangerous situation, but it is going to ramp up. It is going to be overnight. It is going to be multiple days of this once again. Plus what is coming behind this. I have a big update for all of you, plus what happened last night. Now, this is still ongoing, but as of right now, last night, we had 29 tornado reports. We had over 350 wind reports and wind damage reports going on. And for today, still going through, we have another tornado report, plus a lot of strong wind damage that could be from a possible tornado. It's just ongoing. Still a lot of people without power right now. Michigan is at over 105,000 without power. Indiana, almost 60,000. Ohio, right below 30,000. Kentucky at 11,000. Arkansas, over 10,000. Louisiana, over 6,000. There's multiple states, 5,000, 6,000 without power right now. Altogether, a little shy of 300,000 homes without power. Now, Brandon Kopic, he filmed a lot of very strong tornadoes yesterday. And we are talking about some crazy strong tornadoes, everyone. Biggest ones I've ever seen. And this is how it was all evening. All these supercells just all looking with a hook, just looking really bad all night, everybody. Even just hours apart, Selmer and Bethel Springs, Tennessee had multiple strong tornadoes come by just hours apart from each other. And like I said, the strongest storm of the year so far, everybody. Right now, it is sitting at number 3 of all time for 728 reports. And just look how long this night was. This is going to be more of this training over the same areas for today and for tomorrow as well. Then it's going to come right back all the way towards Indiana and Ohio as we go late Friday into Saturday. And don't forget about the flooding. They did put this out. This is a significant and life-threatening flash flooding that is expected to gradually set up this afternoon and extend into the early evening hours. And the latest MESO scale shows that it has that chance for that severity to pick up as we go through the evening. Chances for tornadoes of 120 to 150 miles per hour. Tornadoes possibly. EF2, EF3 plus tornadoes, everybody. Hail, 2 to 3.5 inches again, and winds 55 to 70 miles per hour. Now, for those that have never been here before, make sure you subscribe. My subscribers been knowing since March 21st about this weather pattern. This is where we have our big high pressure coming all the way around with all this moisture. We have a lot of dew points. We have a lot of daytime heating given our instability. And we even had some very strong winds aloft that created all these storms. Now, you can see on your vorticity, you start getting a lot of rotation in the atmosphere as you go through. Later for tonight, also for tomorrow, all the way from the South Central towards Ohio Valley, but it's going to pivot over towards the Northern Ohio Valley, towards the Great Lakes as we go through for Saturday. Then for Sunday, it's going to go across for the southeast. But then we have this cold front coming on through. This is bringing colder temperatures. It's going to bring some more weird snow. Anywhere from Oklahoma towards Kansas, all the way across possibly Missouri, all the way towards the northeast. And when you get just a short trough over here across the Great Lakes, that could bring more snow as we go into next week, Monday through Tuesday, maybe a little bit of Wednesday. And even after that, we might even get another storm system come across for the southeast and the northeast, bringing a lot of winds, bringing chances for snow as well. So once again, you can see this when you look at your pattern again. This is your precipitable water, the high pressure bringing everything around from the Gulf, feeding it all the way till Saturday, going across the southeast for Sunday, and a little bit for Monday as well. Now, our storms are about to really ramp up even more. As you can tell, we start looking like we get some more supercells popping up as we go into the afternoon, and this is where you have the chance for the greatest chance for tornadoes. For Tennessee, northern Mississippi, southern Arkansas, coming from Texas. And this is where these storms are starting to form up as you go through this afternoon and evening, staying in the same area, all the way from western Tennessee, northern Mississippi, through Arkansas, a little bit of central Tennessee as well. And you can see in these significant tornado perimeters that it really stays right along that front for your best chance to spark up a tornado out of this storm cell, even showing still some discrete cells out there in front of the front, which makes it really chance for strong tornadoes on those. As you go by later tonight and overnight, you got some thunderstorms moving towards the east, but some more storms forming up for Kentucky and southern Indiana, and right on the edge of that is where you might build a chance for a tornado once again as you go through the late night hours into the early morning hours. Maybe a QLCS tornado, maybe a quick spin up. And as you go for tomorrow, it's going to grow all again as it goes towards Ohio Valley, towards Illinois, Indiana, Ohio, all the way until Saturday. And this is going to move over as we go through for Sunday. But once again, this is bringing you chances for your tornadoes as that builds up all the way from Missouri and south. So any of these discrete cells that you see popping up in front of there are getting pulled up. And that's where you can get a strong tornado. Plus, you cannot rule out a QLCS tornado along this line of storms coming. Showing as we go through this evening, this is where the hail is going to start popping up from some strong cells all the way from southern Arkansas, northern Mississippi, western Tennessee, going across central and eastern Kentucky, some of West Virginia as well. As you go through for the morning and for tomorrow, look how it climbs all the way from Texas, northern Arkansas, Missouri, a little bit of southern Illinois, and a little bit of western Indiana. But this is where you get some strong cells. Even some strong tornadoes could form over here coming from Texas. You need to be aware of that. Showing as you go through Friday night, this is where it's going to bring those thunderstorms all the way up, all the way from Texas, all the way through Arkansas, southeastern Missouri, Illinois, Indiana, Ohio. Even Michigan's going to see these thunderstorms. As we go through the morning for Saturday, it's going to be there. Get a little surface low, might keep your thunderstorms roaring towards interior northeast as you go through Saturday morning. Then it picks up in the south again as you go through Saturday. Your daytime heating. Here comes your storm system again. Now this is going all the way towards Tennessee, Kentucky, and a little bit of Ohio. Then it carries towards the southeast as you go through for Sunday, bringing the storms all the way from Alabama to Panhandle of Florida, all the way towards the Carolinas. You need to watch out for chances for discrete cells popping through. I think that would be a little bit more extended all the way across the East Coast with that as you go all the way towards Monday morning before it finally pushes through. And so I think the severe weather will stretch another day, everybody. Then we have that cold front coming through. Now, Euro isn't showing anything significant coming with that cold front, but it is seeing that storm system come through as we go through for next weekend. So far, not showing it super strong. Now, there's a difference. As you look with GFS, we go through for tomorrow when that cold front comes through with those storms for Friday all the way till Saturday morning. Then let's go around noontime for Saturday, and here's your severe weather that's going to be happening, but it's bringing the cold air and a wraparound, still showing you can get some snow across northern Texas, Oklahoma, a little bit of Kansas and Missouri while we get our severe weather as it goes across Ohio Valley and interior northeast all the way to late Sunday and Monday morning. Then also showing as we get this cold front coming through after the weekend for Tuesday and Wednesday, we could get another storm system popping up for Illinois, Indiana by Wednesday, bringing a lot of heavy snow all the way towards interior northeast. Just a very rare April snowstorm. This is just crazy what's going on with our weather, everybody. Showing by the latest update with the European that you will get a little bit of snow towards the interior northeast, not a bunch, but a lot for the higher elevations of Colorado, New Mexico, and a little bit more for northern Texas as it goes through Oklahoma. GFS is seeing that heavier as it comes across the south central. Also, the transition as it goes across the interior northeast, bringing in some snowfall as it goes through Tuesday. Then that next snowstorm that comes right behind that, showing that could bring a widespread 9 inches to a foot. Just a very crazy weather pattern. I know it's happened before, but I've never forecasted a snowstorm in April. When we go through the ensembles to see how far-fetched this truly is, the ensembles is coming back a little bit, everyone, where it does have a chance to bring this snow across a little bit more than what it showed before. Some of these really show it could be an inch or two here or there, and it might not be too big for some people. You just see some snow coming across, but you can see it's coming through more ensembles than it did before. So I think it's definitely something we should keep our heads open a little bit too. But if you look towards the northeast, not really trending, no big snowstorm, definitely for the coast. If it does, it will be towards the interior northeast, and that's shown by pretty much all of these, that if you do get any snow, it'd be for western Pennsylvania, western and upstate New York, Vermont, New Hampshire, and Maine. Not looking like it's coming across for New Jersey or Long Island or Massachusetts or any of that. Now, hopefully everyone's been listening to the warnings. After all, it has been about 2 weeks ever since the 21st of March of this warning of this weather pattern. So when this flooding comes, we're going to hear some bad stories. There's going to be all kind of flooding emergencies. And they do have it as potentially historic. They still have it as a generation flood. And catastrophic life-threatening is at hand. So please be aware of this. If you have not heard this before, you need to prepare for this and probably have to leave your area. Still showing by Weather Prediction Center that we're going to get a lot of heavy rainfall, but it's going to be heaviest over here for Arkansas, southern Missouri, southern Illinois, western Tennessee, western Kentucky, far southern Indiana, with the heaviest still being widespread 7-8 inches, which is a bunch in itself, but all the way up towards 10 inches. Now, GFS is still going a little more gangbusters on this rainfall, where it's just going to be a ridiculous amount. Still could get over 15 inches isolated for northern Arkansas, where everyone else is still sitting at that 4 to 6, 4 to 7 inches of heavy rainfall, bringing a lot of flooding. Now, before we go to who's at risk in the new warnings, quick update. Colorado State University has put out their first hurricane outlook for 2025, and they do have it as an above average year, everybody. So here's your new outlooks for who's at risk. This is for today. Your chances for tornadoes as you go through the evening. You still have that 2% to 5% and that narrow corridor of that chance for strong tornadoes. So here's your cities and states at risk for the tornado threat as we go through this evening. And remember, this white line and yellow line on top is your strongest chance for tornadoes. They also have the chance for large hail still. You have the 5%, you have the 15%, but you have the 30% and the significant severe in this block. That means at least 2 inches in diameter. So here's your cities and states at risk for the hail threat as you go through for today. And your wind threat as well. And remember, your wind threat is dialed down a little bit, but you still have chances anywhere from 65 to 70 miles per hour wind gusts that can come through. National Weather Service has severe thunderstorms are likely today along a frontal zone from the southern plains into the lower Mississippi and Tennessee valleys. The most concentrated corridor for severe potential should be focused from the Ark-La-Tex across the Mid-South into Middle Tennessee. Large hail, damaging winds, and a few strong tornadoes are all possible. Now for tomorrow, they have ramped this up, and this is where you have that moderate section. Chances for EF2, EF3 plus tornadoes, everybody. So you do have the 2%, you have the 5% in the brown, the 10% in the yellow, but anywhere from the yellow to the red, you're just chances for a strong tornado. So here's your cities and states at risk for the tornado threat as you go through for tomorrow, for Friday. Once again, the wind threat is somewhat on a mild factor compared to yesterday, but you still have a 5% and a 15%. Here's your cities and states at risk for the damage of winds for tomorrow, for Friday. You have a bigger hail threat for tomorrow. You have the 5%, the 15%, but now you have the 30%, which is chances for large hail, even significant severe in that black. So here's your cities and states at risk for the hail threat for Friday. And the white line and the red line on top is chances for very large hail, 2 to 3 inches. And National Weather Service has several clusters of strong severe storms are possible from central Texas across the Ark-La-Tex and into the lower Ohio Valley Friday and Friday night. The greatest threat for tornadoes, large hail, and damaging winds will be from the Ark-La-Tex across western Arkansas, including potential for strong to potentially intense tornadoes. And when they say intense, they mean EF3 plus tornadoes, everybody. Now, Saturday is still going to be going strong. They did upgrade it to the enhanced feature, and you have the significant severe in that black plus that 30%. Still have chances for strong tornadoes even through Saturday, everybody. So here's your cities and states at risk for the severe weather as you go through for Saturday. And significant severe is chances for 2 inches or greater hail, EF2 or greater tornadoes, and 74 to 75 miles per hour wind gusts or greater. And we still have it on Sunday as it miles down and goes across the southeast. I think this could extend towards the Carolinas as well. But so far, here's your cities and states at risk for that. Thank you so much for your time, everybody. Hope you have a very safe night out there. Please make sure you continuously check on your neighbors. Make sure everybody come out of everything okay. I will see you first thing in the morning. Sorry I was gone for today. If you did check my community tab, I do homeschool, so my kids had testing today, so it was a pretty serious day, and it was a pretty long travel I had to go through to get this testing. So it's always a long travel when you do homeschool, but I'm back. I'm here for you. Thank you to everyone that helped share the information, so now you can see the outcome that's coming of this weather pattern, how serious it is. And we're just now getting to the beginning of the flood threat, which is going to be even worse. You will see. Before I go, Psalm 121, some words from our Father. I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills, from whence cometh my help. My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in, from this time forth, and even forevermore. Amen. Have a great night, everybody. I hope everyone is okay. Remember, all glory does go to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life. And forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Keep us safe, Father. Us and everyone around us.